Welcome back. In this video, we're going to cover how to set up the look and feel of your checkout pages. Now, all of this is taken care of in one screen called the Cart Look and Feel screen. To get there, go up to your Setup menu and select Cart Look and Feel. Now, here we have all of the basic options that are available to us in terms of customizing the look and feel of our checkout pages. Before I make any changes here though, I want to show you what the website looks like that we're going to be using for today's demonstration. We have Dog Training for Beginners, a rather cute little site that sells dog training information products. So what we want to do, the mission here, is to make our checkout pages look as close to our website as possible so that our customers feel comfortable knowing that they're working with the same business from start to finish. So let's go back to One Automation Wiz and see what we have available to us. Now let's take a look at what the cart currently looks like, what our checkout pages currently look like before applying any styling. To do that, simply click the preview link at the top of the page. And here we can see the very standard, sort of industrial looking default checkout page. We definitely want to make this a little bit friendlier, a little bit more like our own website. So now let's go ahead and do some work to that, okay? So here are our options one more time. Now let's look at this background color. My website has a white background and the background color is already pre-configured to white. So I don't need to be doing anything to that to make it match my website. If I did, however, I have a couple of options for changing the color. First, I can choose the color wheel here and select a color that more closely resembles my website. And click select. Or if I know the 6-digit hexadecimal color code for this particular color, I can enter it in the box right here. You have to be careful to keep the pound sign intact at the beginning, and then you can type in your color in 6 digits. If you hit the enter key, that's going to save your changes and update your cart. And as you can see, a message appears that says my cart changes have been saved. Now the accent color will be applied to any hyperlinks or important headings in your cart. Now in my case, if you recall, we were looking here for this teal color. And I'm going to apply this teal color as the accent color in my cart. So I'm going to come back over here. And I happen to know the 6-digit color code, so I'm going to type it in. And hit enter. And it resaves my accent color. My font color was almost black. It was actually a very dark gray. I'm going to go ahead and change that color as well. And I'm going to hit enter. And now I have basically modified the colors of my cart checkout pages. Let's take a look at what my cart will look like. So it doesn't look too terribly different. The main difference is going to be that the teal accent color has been applied instead of that standard blue. And my text here, instead of being solid black, is actually a dark, dark gray. Next, select one of the font families that most closely matches your website. In my case, I'm going to choose Verdana. And now we get to select a company logo, which is going to be displayed at the top of your checkout pages and any other system-generated pages by One Automation Wiz. To do so, click the Select button. And now we're going to choose Upload. And then choose Files. From here, I'm going to navigate to my shopping cart logo image, and I'm going to click open, and then upload to server. Now this has uploaded the image to my media library, but now I need to set it as my company logo. So to do that, make sure you click the checkbox next to the image and click insert. Now, this is my image, and as you can see, it's entirely too big to be used at the top of my checkout page. So I need to resize it. To do that, I'm going to come down here and I'm going to change my width to 700. I'm going to change my height. And then as you can see here, it says that the logo will be resized inside the shopping cart. So it's going to display full size here on your cart look and feel page. But once you look at the shopping cart checkout page, you will see it resized. Now, if you choose not to have a company logo and you just want to have the company name display at the top of your checkout page, make sure that this box here is checked. Otherwise, if you have no logo and this box is not checked, then there will be no business name appearing at the top of your checkout pages, which could be confusing to your customers. If you would like to set a background image for your checkout page, you can do so here by uploading an image just the way we did for our company logo. However, it's important to note that if you choose a background image here, it will override any color that you've selected as your background color up here. So do choose carefully. And finally, if you have a favicon on your website that you would like to mirror here on your checkout pages, go ahead and upload that using the same process. When you're all done setting your cart look and feel settings, click the Save button. And now we can come back up here and see how it looks by previewing our cart. Ah, that looks great, don't you think?